Hey, what's going on, everybody? My name is Drew, and today we're going to learn how to get the Heritage Type Vintage Font Bundle assets into Procreate. I've had a couple people asking me how I've been able to transfer it from something that's typically used with like Illustrator or Photoshop onto Procreate and use them in the same way. So we're going to look at two different ways to do that. First, we're going to look at importing the fonts so that you can use them, manipulate them in Procreate, and then we'll get into the things like the frames and the botanicals and the other assets that are in the bundle. So if you haven't checked it out already, I'm going to link the Vintage Font Bundle for you to go check out. You're going to need an iPad, and you know, if you have a laptop, that'd also be great, speed things up just a little bit. Okay, so I've downloaded the bundle and it's going to unzip as this Vintage Font Bundle. Again, I'm on my laptop. I'm going to show you a really easy way to get it over to Procreate. So when you open it up, this is what it's going to look like: extras, fonts, info, ornaments, and then templates. And so what we're primarily focused on is getting into the fonts. Now, both the OTF and the TTF or TIFF files are going to work with Procreate. I've tried both of them, but we're going to go with the OTF for right now. It's just a newer version, and it definitely works with Mac, so we're just going to go with the OTF for right now. So then we'll open that up. I've already grabbed some of these, but we're going to grab the old Erica, which is funny. The first time I saw it, I thought it said old elk. So there's another potential font for you: Heritage Old Elk, some kind of woodsy cabiny font you could make. Maybe, or I'll make it. Anyway, old Erica, we're gonna pull that. And if you can't figure out how to get it into AirDrop, what you can do is go down to your Finder tab, which you can't see in the window right now, but we'll do new Finder window, go to AirDrop and make it small. And then what I'm gonna do is drag it over, and then you can see here it says iPad, so I'm going to make this just small enough so that I can get it in the window here. Drag the old Erica over to the iPad, and then what's going to happen is up on my iPad, as you can see here, it's going to give me the option to already open it in Procreate. So if I click Procreate here, then it's going to say importing with the little check right there, and then it is already in Procreate. So if we want to double check that, we'll go to add, and we'll just go square for now. Then we'll go to insert text, and then we'll go to fonts, and then we can check. We can scroll down here on the left, and it says old Erica. And then boom, ready to go here, and it's ready to go. So that's the first way that you can get your font files onto your iPad. If you're using like a laptop or like a MacBook, that you could just AirDrop it, and it'll automatically give you the ability to open it up, because if you have Procreate installed, it recognizes it's a font file, and then it saves you all the trouble it imports, and it doesn't have to ask you anything else. Now, let's say you just emailed it to yourself. Then we're going to look at how to do that right now in terms of importing a font. And you might have caught it, but if you go back to edit the type, you can see there in the right hand corner it says import font. Let's do that right now. All right, so let's say that we've emailed it to ourselves instead. So you can see here's the email, and maybe it's a zip drive, and you can unzip it using something like File Explorer or iZip. But anyway, I'll go ahead and click on the file type. Nothing's going to happen. It's just going to tell you what kind of script it is, or what kind of type it is, open type font. And then we will go to this little arrow box in the top right. And what we'll do is we'll go over, and you can actually go ahead and copy it to Procreate, and that's a much easier way to do it. But let's just say for the time being, we don't have the option to do that. It may give you the option, may not. I don't know what kind of iPad you have, but let's just say for right now, we'll save to files. Now it's going to ask you what you want to do. I strongly encourage you have File Explorer. If you don't, I would go ahead and look at grabbing that. But we can go down here, and I've already created a little folder. You can create your little folder, and if you can go to whatever you want to call it, I call it Heritage Font, and I'll go ahead and click save. So now it's saved into that part of the Explorer on the iPad, and it's out of my email. So if we go and we open up Procreate, let's just go back to that same artwork that we had here, and we'll delete that, and we will go to add text. We'll tap on the little A, and then we'll hit import font. Now it's going to give you the option. I've already imported some. It's already going to bring up the heritage font file because I was doing this earlier, but let's say it just opens up File Explorer, or it just opens up on my iPad. You can easily navigate to where it is, go down to where it says heritage font, and then I will click on Marosa. It's going to import, boom. We can scroll down, make sure that it's there, scroll up rather, and there it is, and we're ready to go. Now you can go in here, go back, and you are cooking with some gas. That's another very fast way that you can do it. You might be thinking about, what about all of the other crazy assets, like the frames and the templates and the stuff like that? What we're gonna do is use what Heritage has already given you, which is basically hundreds of PNG files. They're transparent, they're huge files, so they're resizable. You don't have to worry about it, and when you drop them into Procreate, you're gonna be able to easily manipulate and change the color even. And so what we're gonna do is use the first method, the airdrop method, drop it onto Procreate, and then I'll show you how to resize it and how you would use it and maybe trace over it or don't trace over it. So that's up to you. Anyway, let's do that right now. But what we're going to do is go into ornaments and elements. So they've already given you everywhere it needs to go. So this is 2020 Illustrator, which I know works with Illustrator 2021. So if you have that concern, don't be. Illustrator CS, Photoshop Affinity Designer PDF, which is also another project file. It's an Adobe project file, but we're going to click on PNG, and if you click on single elements, all these crazy different style sets are going to come up, and we can preview them and see what they look like, see what we like. But we're going to go into frames because that's usually what people are going to go for, and we'll pick a pretty elaborate one just to see. So there's that one. Let's go with this one. So we'll go with HTC Asset 9. And we'll drag it over to iPad, and then we'll shoot over to the iPad. Now it's going to say, it's going to just basically bring up the picture. Now you can't see it because it's black, but what I'll do is I'll click on the little arrow, and then it'll go to Procreate, send you to Procreate. Now what we'll go is back to Procreate, importing, it's going to tell me yada yada, done. And then you can see here it's made its own kind of embedded thing, and now you can see that it's in here, and it's quite huge. So you can scale it up, scale it down, you can go here, change your color maybe to something like that. What we'll do is we'll alpha lock that layer. You can do that by tapping and clicking alpha lock or swiping with two fingers. Then we'll fill that layer, and you can see that it only applies to what's in the layer. If you try to fill the layer, you can see that what I just did, it made the whole thing red, and that's not what we want to do. So we can play with this, get it whatever color we want, fill the layer with green, which looks not good at all. So what we'll do is we'll kind of find like a very burgundy-ish brown orange type deal. Maybe. And then let's go ahead and insert some text. So we'll add text, we'll go to our fonts, and I really like the Black River right now. I've been using that with pretty much everything. So we'll go in here and just type in heritage type. Actually, we're gonna leave the T lowercase here. Now if you start playing with this, obviously this doesn't fit in here without kind of warping it and maneuvering it. If you start warping and maneuvering things in Procreate, then it is going to rasterize and no longer be able to edit your work. So keep that in mind. You won't be able to edit the work after you've maneuver and, you know, flipped it and whatever. So we're gonna do that right now. We'll go to distort, which is the easiest one to do. And if you grab any of these points, you can start maneuvering how the type sits in this, in this little badge here. And it takes some work to figure out how it's supposed to sit in here. But after you, you know, play with it just for a little bit, it's pretty easy to do. You can do it manually or whatever, and then you can still move it around there with the tool there. And so you can see at the top, text layers rasterized. So now you can't edit this anymore. I can only move it around. If you mess up, you can two finger touch and make it go back to however it is. So obviously this is like not good because we've got some issues here, here, under here. But anyway, you could play with that and really figure out what it is that you're supposed to do all within Procreate with your Apple Pencil. So I hope this has been helpful for you to figure out how to like get your heritage assets into Procreate. It's super easy to do. You know, that was kind of seconds. It didn't take any time at all. And then you can really get that rough kind of sketched look by using different sketch brushes or things like that that you like in Procreate to get even more. You can take it another level and get more vintage. And we'll be doing some more tutorials and things like that to show you how to get those layers and overlap and really get that grungy look. And you can do that in Illustrator, but in my opinion, it takes a lot of work to really get it grungy, whereas you're drawing, you know, electronically, but these brushes have been made so that you can like kind of get it nice and grungy. So we'll be talking about how to get those effects, pulling things from Illustrator into Procreate, pulling them back into Illustrator to get them vector, going from your sketchbook into Procreate, into Illustrator, what have you. Yeah, you guys let me know what you want to see. I'm excited to be doing more videos like this with Vintage Type. I'm excited I got this bundle, and apparently I want another one, so I'm going to get that in and do videos on that, so that'll be great. Like the video and subscribe to the channel. That'd be super groovy. Ending videos is like, do you have a problem ending videos? I'm just gonna end it. So you guys have like a great night, day. Goodbye.